Well, hey everyone, Megan Sumrall here, and I am looking forward to today because today I am going to introduce you to what I call the productivity pyramid. Now, this pyramid is the foundation of pretty much everything that I teach, that I coach, that I share with all of my clients. And I recently held the TOP Bootcamp. TOP stands for Time Management, Organization, and Productivity. And we had a fantastic time in that free 5-day bootcamp, really breaking down the nuts and bolts of this productivity pyramid. And if you missed the bootcamp, don't worry, I will be holding it again. So if you want to make sure that you get on the list to be able to join, just go ahead and look me up on Facebook at Megan Sumrall and go ahead and follow me there, because that is where you will get first access to be able to sign up for the next TOP bootcamp. So I am passionate about all things relating to time management, organization, and productivity. And one of the things I hear over and over and over again from people is, I'm busy, but I'm not productive. And that was a big aha moment that we had in the last bootcamp. So many of the people that attended it were like, wow, I never really, understood that core differentiation of just because you're busy doesn't necessarily mean that you're productive. And it's possible to be super productive and not feel overwhelmed and busy. But there are three key things that you need to know how to integrate together in order to really maximize your productivity. And that is what I call the productivity pyramid. So I'm just going to break down for you here today the three parts of the pyramid, and then a little bit of how, when they all work together, that's where the magic happens. So if you're listening to the podcast, you're not going to be able to see the visual, but for those of you watching here, here is a picture of this productivity pyramid. So you'll see there are three sides to it. The first one is your task list. The second is your schedule. And the third is your structure. So let's talk first about the task list. Most people have some form, variation, flavor, etc. of a task list, right? Now, the challenge is if you don't know how to organize and maintain your task list well, that can lead to some serious problems when it comes to productivity. So when you're thinking about your task list should include truly, absolutely anything and everything that you know that you need to get done, whether it's personal, whether it's business, maybe you have more than one business, maybe it's ideas that you don't want to forget about, but at its core, you need to have one central repository for your task list. It needs to be easily accessible, it needs to be organized, and it needs to be prioritized. And how we go about organizing, prioritizing, and managing it is all the details that I cover in the TOP program, and we teach some of it in the boot camp as well. But that is side one of the productivity pyramid. Now, side two of this pyramid is your schedule. And by schedule, I mean laying out what you're doing and when. A schedule is something most people today are doing electronically. I know a lot of people out there love a Google Calendar, and I use one as well. But I control my schedule, and I own it on my paper planner. Nothing gets put on my electronic calendar unless it's been cleared through my paper planner to start with. And if you're wondering why I choose a paper planner, I'd encourage you to go back and listen to a previous episode here on the podcast all about how to use a day planner. Because when you know how to use it the right way, it is a game changer for you. But your schedule, in talking about it as it relates to the productivity pyramid, I want you to think about what are the things that have specific dates and times that maybe you don't have much control over that are set in stone. So appointments you may make, meetings you have for work, a set work calendar, a set school calendar. So I want you to think about schedule as those kind of non-negotiables. They have to happen at this specific date and time. Now, the third part of this pyramid, and it's what goes along the bottom. So on one side, we've got our task list. On the other side, we've got our schedule. Now at the bottom, and this is the secret sauce, everyone, is structure. And when I'm talking about structure, I'm referring to how you choose to take the things off your task list and implement them into your schedule. You may have a beautifully mapped out schedule. And I have people come to me all the time going, I got this, I'm productive, I'm organized, you know, I got my time managed. And they go and do what I call a time audit, and they go track all the stuff that they've done for the week. And at the end of it, it is a massive realization for them that the structure is completely missing. And so when I'm talking about structure, here's what I want you to think about. Think about how you typically spend your day. Are you someone who is bouncing back and forth and back and forth and back and forth, wearing 10,000 hats and swapping them out all day long? For instance, you're at your desk doing something for 15 minutes. Then you get called in by a kid to go handle something else. Then you've got to jump on a call for work. Then now you're running upstairs to change the laundry. And while you think you're, quote, productive because you're very busy and you're getting a lot of things done, you are collapsing from sheer exhaustion at the end of the day because of that constant, what I call context switching, where you are bouncing from one thing like a ping pong ball all day long. That is, you may have tasks, you may have your schedule, but that is a perfect example of someone who is completely missing the structure part. So when you learn how to implement structure into your schedule and bringing in your task list, that's when you start to have days where instead of running all over the place, you are actually getting significant pockets of time where you are sitting down, you're accomplishing the most important tasks, because we bring prioritization into this as well, and you are aligning them throughout the course of your day, week, and month, so that it is not in this state of being on the hamster wheel. So you're sitting down maybe once a day for 30 minutes and handling all of your email, and then you're done. Or perhaps you are carving out 3 hours of time to just go do something really fun with your kids, and you're leaving your business behind. Then maybe you've aligned your calls so that way you have three of them in a row back to back, and they're all done at once instead of one at 8:30, one at 1 o'clock, one at 4:45 or something like that. So when I talk about that structure part, that is where the magic happens. So I would encourage you to think about right now with your life, which of the parts of the productivity pyramid, the task list being centralized, being prioritized, being organized, the schedule, do you have a central place where you can go to see what needs to be done today or this week or this month? And then finally, the structure. Do you have a thoughtful plan and structure in place to help you know when you should be doing certain activities so that you are not on that hamster wheel all day long? When you marry these three together, that is what is going to allow you to skyrocket right through that pyramid and start to get massive results with your productivity without working any harder. So I hope that this is giving you some food for thought. I definitely encourage you, if you do not already kind of follow me on social media, either Facebook or Instagram, go ahead and do that, because if this has piqued your interest and you're realizing maybe you need some help in these areas, I want you to come join the next top boot camp. That will be the next one is scheduled for August. So August of 2020, depending upon when you are listening to this. But this is something that I do hold often. So if you are following me, you will get a notification on when the next boot camp is open. It's a completely free boot camp, and it will really help you get your head around all the parts of the pyramid and set you up to be able to skyrocket your productivity too. Have a great one.